went from cleansing from sin. I cried dead to my heart. What's the blood applied? Glory to His name.
You today, Lord God, we cannot make it this far without you. It's by your mercy and your grace that I'm standing right here. It's your mercy and your grace that take us from day to day. Many times we fell down, Jesus, and you lift us right back up and dust us off and told us to keep going, keep running, keep pressing, keep pulling, keep believing, keep standing, because I'm with you all the way. So God, I thank you for your anointing power to just rain down. We give it all to you. Do what you're going to do, God, because it belongs to you. We thank you for your resurrecting power. We thank you because we know that you're here in this earthly realm because you came back just for us. You came from the grave, God, that we may have a right to the life, a tree of life, God. We may have a right to it. So God, we thank you on today. We praise you. We worship you. And everyone that agree, give God some praise and say, Hallelujah!
That's right, glory to God. Make some noise in the SOV today, y'all. Amen. And again, I got my lovely co-host, Pastor Leah, another extraordinary young lady. And again, she's going to give everybody a warm welcome. I'd like to invite Pastor Gloria to the stage.
Welcome to Saints of Zion Ministerial Training Center, everybody. For this evening, we represent and love on God with the blessing of the shofars. I say sit back, stay in, and press into what God has for you on today. Amen.
In the midst of my pain, in the midst of my shame, in the midst of my hurt, right there in the midst of all of my shame, when tears roll down my face,
that's right,
so much like rain. Lift your hand and say, I call to Jesus. Because he is my everything.
Everything.
You are my everything. Jesus, you are, my everything. Jesus, you are. Yes, you are, Jesus. You're my everything. My everything is you. Oh Lord, you are. You're my everything. In the middle of my pain, Lord, you're my everything. When I can't go on, Jesus,
hallelujah,
you're my everything.
Amen.
My everything is you. In the midst of your shame, just begin to worship Jesus.
Just worship.
In the midst of your heartache and your pain, just begin to worship.
Just worship.
The Bible said when a praise go up, a blessing come down. So when you give God your best praise, your best worship, God said, I'm going to show up and I'm going to show out in your situation. What the devil has done for evil, God said, I have to turn around for my glory and for your good. You will stand and know that I'm with you. In spite of what you're going through, just trust me as I bring you through the storm. Hallelujah. Oh Lord. You're my peace of mind. In the middle of my storm, Lord, you're my peace of mind. When I can't go on, Lord, hallelujah, you're my peace of mind.
Thank you, God.
Thank you for making us whole once again, Jesus. When the devil came in like a rushing flood and tried to take our joy, thank you for showing up in our situation, Jesus. Lord, we can't live without
giving you the praise, giving you the honor, giving you the glory, thanking you for what you begun, that you're faithful and just to complete it. For you alone have, Father. God, we just want to thank you. We want to praise you. We're celebrating you today, Father God. We come before you repenting of our sins. We don't want nothing to block our blessings. So right now we're doing a soul check, Father. Any ought against anybody, we choose to forgive them because it's a choice. And God, we just thank you and we praise you and we glorify you. Now, Father, we welcome you. We continue to welcome you in here. And Father, as I open my mouth wide, I pray that you will fill it and that I will decrease and you will increase in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, that the word will go forth with accuracy, accomplishing those things that you set out before the foundation of the world. And Father God, we're so careful to give you the praise. All the glory is only yours. And we thank you and we praise you. And those in agreement says, amen, amen. Let's give the Lord a praise. Amen, 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 amen. Well, I'm not going to be before you that long, and I'm asking each speaker to take about 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and then we're going to flow at the end. Amen. What I'm going to be talking to you about is Passover. So if you have your Bibles, everybody brought their Bibles, right? Their sword, their weapons, and they're equipped right now. Amen. Amen. You know, 8 years ago, we were here, Pastor Roday, and that was the first time that we actually I've been a Christian for, gosh, since 1981. Well, if you go back when I was a little girl, Baptist little girl, got baptized, that's a lot of more years, too. I guess about 55 years, if you count them. So I started singing when I was 5. Now everybody know I'm 60. Hallelujah, glory. I was about 5 years old, and I started to sing and open up programs. And, you know, I, being brought up in a good Baptist church, you know, I didn't know nothing about tongues. I didn't know a lot about a lot of things. But just recently, the Holy Spirit allowed me to just, and a lot of Christians don't even realize how important Passover is. You know, like I was sharing, we began Passover in this building about 8 years ago. Amen. Pastor Aretha was here, too. Yeah, thank you. Praise the Lord. Everybody know Pastor Aretha. You know, she's a beautiful lady. That's a movie star right there, if y'all know it. But anyway, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So about 8 years ago, we started, and you know, I stand before you. I am not a rabbi or a great scholar or any of that. I don't really know, per se, but what I've learned about Passover, but I do know I know him. And he just led me on how to do the Passover. And tonight there's such a freedom in this place. And so those of you, how many people in here that really never ever kept Passover and never realized it's our heritage? How many people know that? I mean, it's okay, I didn't know it. It was okay, I'm sorry. Thank you, Venus. I did not know that. Come on, let me see your hands. Shame the devil, come on. Don't be, y'all ain't that deep. Y'all better learn some. Hallelujah, because I know I didn't know, and I've been preaching for a long time, 33 years. So anyway, about the Passover. So I want you to open your Bibles to Exodus 12. And again, I need somebody to time me because I don't want to be up here all day and all night. I'm going to make this quick, sweet, and to the point. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're going to begin Exodus 12. Amen. When you have it, say praise the Lord, hallelujah, and thank you. It says, verse 7, then they shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat. They shall eat the flesh that night, roast on fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. They shall eat it. Do not eat any of it raw or boil in water, but roast it. Its head with its legs and its inner parts. Uh-oh, didn't even gut it out. And you shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning, you shall burn it. 11, in this manner you shall eat it with your belt fastened, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. Ye shall eat it in haste. That means hurry it up. It is the Lord's Passover. Now that's deep right there. This is the Lord's Passover. You know, we have seen the Lord's Supper so many times, the Last Supper. Look at somebody and say, do you know the Last Supper? That was the Passover. Jesus was keeping the Passover. That's awesome. And then it says, And you know, a lot of things, it's not, and I like that it says the Lord's Passover. That means it's not the Jewish Passover. That's the Lord's Passover. So that means it's my Passover. Anybody else know what I'm talking about? Number 12, for I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will, who is I? God. I will strike all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both man and beast, and all the God, look, G, of Egypt. I will execute judgment. I love that word, judgment. How many people like judgment? Y'all should be raising y'all hand doing acrobats. See, let's just imagine this. When you say, what? If you was in a court of law, okay? And you have the plaintiff and the defendant. And then what the judge do, he goes, the judgment is made. Now, so many times we want to take judgments as negative. But I'm on the judgment of winning. Hello? Did y'all catch that? Did y'all catch, how many people like judgment? Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Especially, you know, greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world, and everything you put your hands on prosper. And God said goodness and mercy is following us, and the blood of Jesus washes us white as snow. So when we stand before him, the judgment. Yes. Hello? Y'all better catch that thing. Judgment. See, the blood was over the houses, but that death angel has to pass over that firstborn of cattle. And so he got to pass over. Anyway, let me get before. Let me see, a lot of people, they like to have that word. Pastor Jason, you know they want to have the word. Say, you know, until you preach. Okay. Okay, let's keep going. It says, and it says, I am the Lord. 13, blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague will befall you to destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. Hello? Look at somebody, say hello. 14, this day shall be for you a memorial. Now, I love this. And you shall keep it as a feast to the Lord. You're keeping it as a feast to the Lord throughout your generations. A statute for how long? Hello? So we need to be keeping Passover. So I'm a Christian. And you don't know nothing about Passover. Okay, I'm tying this thing up and I'm almost done. Keep my time, somebody. You shall keep a feast. What? You shall keep a feast out of your a feast. Of your house, for it is, I'm sorry, for if anyone eats what is leavened, okay, on the first day you shall remove leaven, I'm sorry, out of your house. For if anyone eats what is leavened for the first day until the seventh day, see, it lasts for 7 days, in some places eight, the person shall be cut off from Israel. That leaven represents our sins. You will get cut off. We need that blood. And come on, let me hurry up. Exodus 12. Then Moses, 21, I'm at 21 now. Then Moses called all the elders of Israel and said to them, go select a lamb for your families and slaughter. I like the slaughterhouses up in the house. Anyway, slaughterhouse. Okay. And slaughter the Passover lamb. How many know that Jesus is the lamb? See, he came first as a lamb, and a lamb is compassionate and meek and gentle. But how many know he's coming back as a lion? Oh. Okay. Take the branches of hyssop and dip them in the blood that is in the basin, and touch the lintel and the two doorposts with the blood of the basin. None of you shall go outside the door. You better stay in God. You better stay up in God, especially right now, because judgment is falling. People falling dead. You better stay up in here in the spirit, amen, of your house until morning. That's mean the coming of the Lord. So it's good morning. I'm going to fly away when that trumpet blow. Anyway, okay. For the Lord shall pass through to strike down the Egyptians. When he sees the blood on the lintel and on the two doorposts, the Lord will pass over the door and will not allow the destroyer. This is keeping the Passover and doing what God said. He will not allow the destroyer to enter into your houses to strike you down. Because we're covered in the blood. So that's power in the blood. You know, the old folks, you say, I plead the blood. You know, somebody may call me sometime, and I'll say, well, the blood of Jesus. They tell me, the blood of Jesus. You'll hear me say, well, glory. I ain't got no comment, but glory. Glory. And then they say, the blood. That's our weapon. Yes. Praise the Lord. And the power has never, what does the song say? It has never lost its power. And when I think about that blood, see, Cain and Abel, they had, you know what happened? He spilled his brother's blood, and that blood started crying out. But see, the blood of Jesus is crying out for us today. The blood of Jesus is calling your name. The blood of Jesus is our healing. The blood of Jesus is our deliverance. The power in the blood. You got a weapon with the blood of Jesus. This is the highest holy day ever. This is the new year, hallelujah, of the blood of Jesus. Passover is the new year. Did y'all know that? And Jesus. Okay, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Shall. So it says the destroyer to enter into your houses to strike you down. So when you're covered in the blood, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Hallelujah. He's got his angels that are encamped around us. He got Holy Ghost angels. He had a little Sata camped around us. Warring angels, ministering angels. We can't help but win. That same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwelleth in our mortal body. Do you know what I'm talking about? We got Almighty is upside of us. How dare a sickness or disease touch thy anointed God? You got to speak and declare some things until the kingdom and spit it out into the atmosphere and watch and see God change things. The day shall be, Exodus 13:9, for your memorial, ye shall keep it as a feast to the Lord throughout your generation. So every Passover, y'all need to get happy. Y'all need to be dancing because we win. Hallelujah. Woo! Anyway, and it says to keep it forever. All right, I'm going to go over to Exodus 23:15, and this is when Pastor Mel Brewer is going to be talking about. It says, do not stand before God empty-handed. Exodus 23:15. God commanded Israel to honor him with bringing a Passover offering to the house of the Lord. You know, I was sharing with Pastor Cocott. Praise the Lord, I was sharing with Pastor Cocott. And I was saying, you know, we was talking about how people tithe and how they give. And, you know, we were just discussing some things. But before you even get to the church, you should have already had an encounter. God, what do you want me to give today? We do not have to trick and put, say, $100 line and this the Lord gonna do this. You give $500. But you should already have that in a counter with the Holy Ghost. People sitting up, prophet, you know, telling you this stuff. And see, I love prophesying, and you gonna say, oh, I better get my rent. You better pay your rent. You better pay your rent. Pay. Check out somebody. Pay your rent. Give me that $800, $1,000. Oh, Lord, I can feel it. And they walking around and they eating, driving Rolls Royces and stuff. Not everybody, but they driving Rolls Royces and sucking, beating the lamb, beating the sheep, and taking their money. And that's right out there in YouTube TV. You going on. Stop taking these sheep money. The Lord going to get you. So the sheep should already been taught. When you come to the house of the Lord, you know what, you bring your best. And see, that's another thing. God ain't asking you for everything. Look at somebody. He ain't asking you for everything. He asking you for your best. You know, I love to give an illustration really quick. Creflo Dollar gave this story. He said the Lord told him to give away a suit. And he loved that suit. So he went upstairs and he said, I don't want to get my best suit. I'm going to get that suit. So he came down, get the man first seat, second suit, third seat. And every time the suit, and the Lord said, see, you ain't ready. Oh, God, I'm ready. And then he finally went up and got the man's suit that he wanted. The man did somersaults, happy about to get a seat. He said, well, Lord, I'm guess you happy now. I done get that guy 5 suits. He said, I only told you to give him one. That's why you gotta listen to what God says. So we need to teach our people on how to give. Yes, you bring your best to him. And whatever he tell you, just step out on faith because he can talk to you. Amen. See, the veil has been torn. So you don't have to go to the priest and whoever else, you know, Dr. JoJo or whoever. But just do what God says do. Yes, he can speak, but it should be a confirmation. And if it's not a confirmation, put it on the back burner into God. Confirm it because he can talk to you. Anyway. That's the sidebar. Hallelujah. So don't come before the Lord empty-handed. I'm almost done. I hope I ain't going too long here. Okay, so we're talking about giving an offering of Passover. It's a springtime. It's a new season in your life. So, and then there are some blessings that are attached to that. And I know they're going to go into a little bit more detail. But when you see, he assigns an angel to you. See, that's that blood of Jesus. And he had to pass over. And he'll be an enemy to your enemies. That means that's when they were in Egypt and they got drowned in the Red Sea. And he will take care of your enemies. And then he'll give you prosperity. Let me tell you, when they left out of Egypt, they was not poor. The shoes didn't even wear off on their feet, but they took gold, they took cattle, they came up out of there loaded. So he gonna give you some prosperity. He'll take sickness away from you. He said, not a feeble one amongst them. Wow. Hello, 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 hello. Physically and spiritually, you're gonna have a long life. That means I'm gonna live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. Hallelujah. And this is what I like too. He'll bring increase. An inheritance. See what your grandmama been paying for, and auntie been praying, and all them head folks up there. That's gonna be your blessing. That's your inheritance. Hello. This is why keeping the Passover. This is heavy. Thank you, Holy Ghost. And then he'll give you a special year of blessing and expand your borders. So with that in mind, I just wanted to kind of bring you. Just give you a little shadow of Passover. You know, it's so much more to it. And as my brothers and sisters come forth a little bit, we're just going to go in deeper into Passover and grab the vision. Because you know what he told me? It's been 11 years. Oh, this is so awesome. Today is what? What's today? What? The 29th? March 29th. Y'all know what the date is? March 29th, 2013. Okay. And it was 11 years to the day that we moved into this place. The very first service, and today is the last service. In this, as we minister. That's telling me something. 11 years to the day? And God also told me that 2013, everybody said that what they, you know, 2013 meant this, 2013 meant that. But what he told me specifically, because I have a personal relationship, he told me this is my year of promise.
Yeah.
So I am not sad about leaving this building.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Look at somebody say, are you kidding her? Anybody got a new car? Anybody got a new car lately? And they had an old car, and that car, you had to push it, and it got flats and always running hot. Anybody know what I'm talking about? And then when you got your new car, did you sit up and think about your old car?
No.
Thank you. Okay. Praise the Lord. Well, with that in mind, I pray that bless you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's just stand to our feet.
Here again today in his house and on this wonderful, wonderful day. And as I talk tonight on the Passover and I think of the scripture that was given to me, don't stand before the Lord empty-handed. And Pastor Vicky went over some of the things from Exodus 23. But when I thought about the seven specific blessings, if you just think about where God has brought you already from January 1 to this present day. And when I think that God says he will assign an angel to you, everyone in here has an angel. You don't know when that angel will be activated in your life, but they're there every day. But then it will come a day that you will really need and depend on that angel. All of you have gone through sickness. You've lost someone. And God already knew what you would go through, but he assigned an angel to you. It also said it will be an enemy to your enemies. You know, we got enemies. We got folks who don't like us. And when you say you preaching and teaching the word of God, you're going to have more enemies. And when you get those enemies, sometimes you don't know how to deal with it and what to do. But God said he will be an enemy to your enemies. You got to just give it to him and don't go back and pick it up. He said he would also give you prosperity. A lot of people think when they say give you prosperity, that means you're going to get you a house, a car, and money. Prosperity is good health. Prosperity is knowing that you ain't got no illness in your body. Prosperity is knowing that God is good all the time. Whether you got a box of oatmeal on the cupboard or you're eating a steak, God said he would give you prosperity. He said also he would take sickness away from you. You don't know how you will be in that situation until you are in that situation. And I know I have a testimony to know that God is truly a healer. When the devil would make it seem as though you getting ready to check up out of here, God said he will take the sickness away from you. He said he will give you long life. All of us in this room, we still young. But on last week, I lost an uncle, my husband's uncle. He was 96 years old. So I would say God gave him a long life. And he was a minister of the gospel and preached it for over 50 years. And tomorrow as we go through his homecoming, I know where he is at. He's already with his daddy enjoying all the things that he has worked for so long. He said he would bring an increase and an inheritance to your life. All of us in here's children in this room. And parents, if you don't train them up right, you won't leave an inheritance for them. See, God's word is true. He said that he will bless all that we do. And we got to go back and get our babies. We got to teach them. And then God also said he would give us a special year of blessing. When Pastor Vicky said this is her year, I believe it in all my heart. Because see, you know when God is doing something miraculously. When I came to SOV and I remember walking into this building, and I think of all the ministers and evangelists who have come through that door. And we served up under a woman who's anointed and appointed to do what God has called her to do. And you know, when you obey your leader and follow in subjection to your leader, God said he's gonna bless the things that you do.